My name is Casey Langan. I'm a software engineer for Amazon.com, and I wrote the Amazon MP3 store app for Android. Let me show you how it works. So you'll notice on the home screen there's easy access to all the major features. There are the top 100 albums, top 100 songs. These are updated hourly. You can browse by genre, or you can search, and search is what I'll demo for you today. So I'm going to tap the search button, and I'm going to select Hendrix. I want to look at some Jimi Hendrix albums. I'm interested in purchasing this blues album, so I'm going to tap it. I'll be presented with an album detail page, which contains all the tracks on the album. I can scroll around in here and preview tracks in place, so I can just tap Voodoo Child Blues. Okay, I like this song, so I'm going to go ahead and purchase it, so I'm going to press this price button. I will tap again to confirm. As soon as the purchase completes, my downloads will be queued and I'll be presented with this download screen. And as soon as this track finishes downloading, it'll be automatically added to the music app. So, select albums. Notice here's the blues album, and here's Voodoo Child Blues. So that's how I use the Amazon MP3 store app. Amazon is really interested in reaching as many people on as many different platforms as possible, so the move to the mobile market seemed very logical. Android made that really easy. We use the Apache HTTP client to download metadata from our web services. We make extensive use of the list view. In fact, I think we use the list view in every activity in our application. And we also use the media player quite a bit for song previews.